exciting because as society has evolved, so has Miss America. And I say my job is Miss America, you know, I change locations every 48 hours. I travel about 20,000 miles a month. And I haven't worn a swimsuit since the day that I won the pageant or the competition. And so it's so important to realize that, you know, this is a scholarship organization and scholarships don't equal swimsuit. And these women are up there telling us, you know, what it is that they're passionate about, showcasing their intelligence. And that doesn't mean wearing a swimsuit.
Okay, so it's besides the swimsuit competition, there's also other changes as well to all of this as well. The gown situation as well. Yes. So maybe walk our viewers who might be seeing this story for the very first time, exactly what changes Miss America will be making for the next one.
Yes, well, our candidates now have the option to choose how they want to depict formal wear. So they can wear an evening gown like how I did, but they could also wear a cocktail dress. Mm-hmm. They could wear a pantsuit,
so
a jumper.
Essentially whatever they feel comfortable in.
Yes, yes, whatever it is that you want to depict on that stage. We're also going to be having a little bit more where you get to know the contestants. And that's one thing when I won Miss America, what many people don't realize is I had a 10-minute private interview before that. We're talking controversial topics, making sure that I have my opinion on, you know, what that is, knowing what's going on in our world. It is a scholarship organization, so you should be up to date on it. And for the audience not to see any portion of that area of competition, it's difficult because you say, you know, yes, you saw me in an evening gown. Yes, you saw my talent, but you didn't really get to know me. And now we'll get to know the candidates.